Good morning, Chairman Blunt, Ranking Member Klobuchar. It's great to be here with all of you, including our good friend Senator Collins and the rest of the members of this committee. As a proud Texan and a senator from a border state, I've been fortunate to experience firsthand the tremendous influence of Latinos on our country and culture throughout my life. From learning the stories of the brave soldiers who fought in the Texas Revolution to experiencing the vast influence of the Hispanic culture in my hometown of San Antonio, I'm incredibly proud and appreciative of the Latino influence on Texas and American life. Unfortunately, for many Americans, the contributions of generations of Latinos are largely unknown, and I hope this committee will soon take action to right this wrong by advancing legislation to establish a national museum of the American Latino. This effort has been underway for more than 25 years. I note Senator Collins talking about the long journey of the Women's Museum. These museums are not hastily established. And I think a lot of thought has gone into both, but in particular, the Latino Museum has been a idea that whose time has now come for more than 25 years. In the 1990s, the Smithsonian Institution commissioned a report to examine the relationship between the museum and Latinos. It was entitled, notably, Willful Neglect. And those two words adequately sum up the findings. For everything from a lack of exhibits to curators to staff, Latinos were excluded at virtually every level of the world's largest museum complex. According to a 2018 report by UCLA, not much progress has been made. Latino representation within the Smithsonian is still far from what it should be, even as the Latino population in America has doubled. One of the recommendations of the initial 1994 report to improve representation of Latinos was through the establishment of a museum dedicated to the contributions of Latino Americans. As I said, that was more than 25 years ago, and Congress has not yet authorized this critical museum. With the support of this committee and this Congress, I hope that will change. Every year, millions of Americans visit the Smithsonian to learn about our nation's complex and fascinating story and the men and women who helped write it. These museums teach us about American presidents, soldiers, artists, astronauts, innovators, icons, and heroes of every breed. They house priceless artifacts of American history, from the Star-Spangled Banner, which inspired the national anthem, to the hat that President Lincoln wore the night he was assassinated. For too long, these museums haven't told the whole story of the rich diversity of our country. That's slowly changing due to the recent additions of the National Museum of the American Indian and the National Museum of African American History and Culture, but we still have a ways to go. The process of creating a National Museum of the American Latino began in 2008 in earnest when President George W. Bush established a commission to study the feasibility of such a museum, and again, when their report was released in 2011. Now that it's been nearly a decade since the commission formally recommended this museum be built, it's time to act. The National Museum of the American Latino Act authorizes the Smithsonian Institution to create a museum honoring American Latinos here in Washington, and I'm proud to have introduced this with our colleague, Senator Menendez, in a bipartisan fashion. This Congress, nearly 300 members of the House have co-sponsored this legislation, and it unanimously passed the House earlier this year. The bill has 46 co-sponsors here in the United States Senate, and I hope the committee will soon favorably report this bill to the floor so we can send it to the President's desk before the end of this Congress. It's been more than 25 years since this effort began. It's time to honor the contributions of generations of Latinos by providing a brick-and-mortar home for their stories right here in our nation's capital. So thank you again, Mr. Chairman and Ranking Member Klobuchar, for allowing me to join you here today to talk about this important step. And I'm happy to answer any questions you might have, or failing that, I'll go back to the Judiciary Committee.